If you love baking cakes from scratch as much as I do, then maybe you already have a really good vanilla buttercream recipe. But I can tell you that my extra creamy vanilla frosting is not only the creamiest I've ever made, it's also the creamiest frosting I've ever painted. Now don't get me wrong, this isn't as fluffy as an Italian or a Swiss buttercream, but considering how much faster and easier this version is, I think you're gonna be pretty happy with the results. So I have here 2/3 of a cup of butter and 1/3 of a cup of margarine. If you don't like the idea of using margarine, go ahead and use straight butter, but I honestly believe the margarine does something to make this fluffier. So beat that for about 30 seconds, and now I'm gonna start adding in some confectioner's sugar. Now as I do this, I always like to stop the beaters and mix it manually like this at first. That way the sugar doesn't go flying all over the place and make a big mess in the kitchen. So, something good to remember. I'm gonna keep adding in that sugar. Don't forget to stop and scrape down the sides of the bowl every now and then. It's very important. Getting all that sugar properly incorporated will prevent our frosting from being lumpy, because nobody likes lumpy frosting, guys, it's no good. So I'm gonna use up a total of 405 grams of confectioner's sugar, which is also known as powdered sugar or icing sugar, depending on which part of the world you're from. So we've added all our sugar in now. Here comes our secret ingredient, 1 teaspoon of boiling water. And it has to be boiling, guys. Don't just use really hot tap water. It's not the same. And no more than 1 teaspoon. Now I've tried adding in milk and cream, but nothing seems to make this frosting fluffier than boiling water, at least I find. Some of you pastry chefs might be screaming at me right now, but hey, you gotta use what works. Finally, I'm gonna flavor this with 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract and 1/4 teaspoon of almond extract. That adds a really nice touch. And I'm using salted butter today, but if your butter is unsalted, then add in 1/4 teaspoon of salt right now. And that's it, guys. Mix that in until it's super smooth. I hope you give this recipe a try. If you do, don't forget to leave me a comment and let me know how it worked out for you.